To begin with our painting, we will paint the miniature's armor silver, leave the cape and the bow for later painting, and also leave some space on the back of the leg and the sleeve. We're going to paint the cape while the armor dries out. When the paint on the armor fully dries up, we can move on to the back of the legs now. Then comes the tricky part, the shoulder of the knight or the sleeve. You will notice that the knight is holding the arrow over his chest, therefore covering some of his shoulder, the one we were supposed to paint. But it's okay, you can cover the excess paint over later on when we start to paint the arrow and the bow. The color I use for the bow and arrow is a metallic reddish gold, which will turn out closer to bronze than gold. Wash your miniature with a darker color to bring out the detail in the armor. Even the slightest detail will pop up when you use this technique. That's the Silver Knight Greatbowman from the Dark Souls board game.